Hey guys, welcome to Sakre Cubes. This is Sagar. So today I have come to Chikmagaluru. We are staying in this beautiful homestay called as Giri Light Estate. So we left from Bangalore at 8 o'clock and we reached here at 2 o'clock. We just now we had lunch and we are leaving now. So the plan for today is we'll be going to Mullayangiri. After that we'll go to Baba Budangiri and we'll come back here, we'll have dinner, we'll play some card games and we'll sleep. On the next day we'll go to Hebe Falls and we'll be back to Bangalore. I have covered most of the places in Chikmagaluru during my last two visits, so this is more of a leisure trip. We are leaving now to Baba Budangiri and Mullayangiri, so let's start it. Well guys, it's 4 o'clock in the evening. We have reached Mullayangiri. We have parked our vehicle right there and we are walking towards the peak. So basically when you come here from the parking, you basically have to take the steps. There are around 500 to 600 steps you have to take to reach the peak. Behind me you can see a small temple. This is a Mullappa Swami temple. To talk a few things about Mullayangiri is that this is the highest peak in Karnataka, which is about 6300 feet tall above the sea level. We spent a couple of time taking photos here. We just visited the temple and we are taking a couple of photos here. There is a very beautiful view all around the buildings. You see, that's the Chikmagaluru city, and all around you see all hills and it's a really beautiful view here. We will spend another 15 minutes here and we'll go to Baba Budangiri next. It's 4:45 in the afternoon and the climate is not that hot. It's a little sunny, but it's really cool here. It's 5:30 in the evening and we are still at Mullayangiri. What happened was Baba Budangiri was a kilometer drive from here, so it was already 5 o'clock, so we decided not to go there because it will take a lot of time till we go there and it will get darker. So we decided to just stay here and watch the sunset and we'll go. So that is the main viewpoint, so there's so many people there. We decided to come on the other side of the hill and we are just sitting here chilling out. The view is amazing. And there are some pre-wedding photo shoots going on at the back end. So we'll just sit here, watch the sunset and we'll go back to the room. For now, I'll keep the sunset time lapse. You guys can just enjoy. Our second stay in the Chikmagaluru. I am currently walking in the coffee estate and below you see that is our cottage where we are staying. It was really cold at night. After coming back from Mullayangiri, I couldn't really vlog. We just came here, we just had our dinner and we slept. We played some card games in the night and it's 8 o'clock in the morning. Everyone got up, we'll have breakfast and we'll leave for either Baba Budangiri or Hebe Falls. Let's see where we will go. Currently the view is superb. The sun has already come up and we are just walking in the coffee estate. This is how the climate is looking. Well, you see the plants here. These are the coffee plants and these are the coffee beans. It does look really beautiful, just see that. that's our stay. So if you are staying in, make sure you stay in one of those cottages. There are basically two cottages, one is here and other is there. So you basically have to stay in those cottages to experience the beauty of Chikmagaluru here.
We are going to Jhari Falls. We took this jeep ride. It cost you around 700 rupees from the road to the Jhari Falls for 2 and 4 for 7 people. Even if you are less than 4 or 7 people, you can just combine with others and you can go. The road is really bad.
Well, due to time constraints, there was a little change in the plan, so we decided to visit Jhari Falls and then if possible we'll visit Halebidu and Shettihalli while going back. We are not going to Hebe Falls nor Kemangundi, so we'll just visit the Jhari Falls and we'll go back to Bangalore. This is the third time I'm coming to this waterfalls. The first time we came, we just walked from the main road till here. The second time we took the jeep ride and this is the third time. Finally we can see the waterfalls. Looks like there is plenty of water. We will be playing in the water here. I think the water would be very cold to take shower here, but still we have to make our guts and get into the water. You see behind me is the Jhari Falls. We took a shower in the waterfalls. The water was really ice cold and we just took it. It was amazing experience to take bath here. And I think there are a lot of people here. The crowd is more, since it's Sunday, the crowd is too much. The waterfalls from almost 60 feet above, so there are three stages, that is the peak. And you can actually go till here also, and you can go till here and you can take bath here as well. So this is the most beautiful waterfalls in Chikmagaluru apart from Hebe Falls. I'll show one very interesting thing. You can actually see the rainbow. You can really see the rainbow here. From Jhari Falls, we started riding back to Bangalore. On the way, we visited Beluru Chennarayakeshwara temple and we have finally reached this place. Just check this out. Well, yes, this is Shettihalli church. It was there in my list since very long and finally I am here. We have currently parked the car here. I'm not really sure if we can get it there. There's a little bit of water in the front, so I'm really unsure if we can really take the car there. I hope, let's see if there is a possibility to take the car. I'll just take the car there. To talk few things about Shettihalli church is that it was constructed in 1860 and it was submerged in water in 1960. From 1960 it was completely abandoned. So it is a great place for photography. So if you are photography enthusiast or if you just want this place for pre-wedding photo shoot, then this is the place for you. You can just come for a casual ride and you can enjoy the beauty around. This is so beautiful. Anyways, this is all about my trip to Chikmagaluru and Hasan. We'll be leaving now. It's already 6 o'clock, so it will take another 4 hours to reach Bangalore. So we'll have dinner on the way and we'll reach home. If you are liking what you are watching, make sure you subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and see you in the next one. Bye bye.